Hi everyone, it's me, Cricket Chick, here bringing you Let It Wobble Tuesday, episode number 5. So let's get started by congratulating our winner for the last episode number 4, and that winner is number 7, Gail. So congratulations, Gail. Gail left a comment on the post for episode number 4 saying, "Julie, I love Wobbles. I love your videos as well. Thanks for getting us inspired. Sorry your internet has been down." That's a bummer. Enjoy your week, Gail. Well, Gail, my internet is finally back up. It was up, of course, in order to post that video. And you are the lucky winner of the 6-pack of Wobbles. So I'll be sending them your way. I just need you to send me your address. And you can send that to the cricketchick@rocketmail.com. And I will be happy to get those out in the mail to you right away. Also, just so everybody knows, Gail does have a website, or I'm sorry, she has a blog, and it's called I Like Paper. That is the cutest name of this blog. I love it. I Like Paper. I love paper. So you can go to her blog and see her over at ilikepaper01.blogspot.com, and she needs some followers. So I would really love it if you guys would go show her some support and become a follower of her blog. So that's it. Congratulations, Gail, and I'll look for your address real soon. Thanks. So, let's move on to the wobble card that I'm doing this week. So, I decided that I'm going to just go ahead and do a card this time instead of candy. And I'm doing a Thanksgiving theme this time since I'm kind of Halloweened out. I love Halloween, but I've done enough Halloween. So, I'm moving on. After this, I'll probably start on Christmas. So, here we go. What I'm doing this time is I took a 12 by 6 sheet of cardstock. Well, I cut it 12 by 6 and then I scored it at 6 inches, so I'm going to do a 6 by 6 card. And what I did was cut my matte section, which is this cream color one. I cut the matte at I actually like mine to have a little more space around the edges. A lot of people do them at the eighth of an inch, but I like to do a quarter. So my mat layer is actually 5 3/4 inches. And then the top layer is going to be 5 1/2. So that's how I do mine. And anybody that knows me knows that I always do the inside of my cards. So I've actually cut 2 of those. I will take this and this top layer here. I'll actually cut it 2 1/2 inches. So I didn't do that yet, but I'll cut it at 2 1/2 inches, so it'll be 5 1/2, and then the ribbon will go here. So it usually pretty much always looks like the outside. I won't do this, I won't do this for this post, but I will do it, I'll do it afterwards, just so you know, to always cut out too if you want to do the insides of your cards. So what we're doing today, very, very, very simple card. So all I'm going to do is take the matte layer here, and I'm going to glue down the top layer to the matte layer. Sorry, I still have this horrible cold. I just cannot get rid of it. And I'm coughing all the time. It's so nagging. Went to the doctor about this a long time ago, like last year when I had it. And the doctor actually said, "Oh yeah, that's the 100-day cough," or something ridiculous like that. I'm like, "100-day cough?" She's like, "Yeah, it usually lasts for about 100 days. She said, "I really don't have a reason why, but usually everybody has this ridiculous cough for like 100 days. That's crazy. So it was really funny because all of a sudden it just went away last year. So hopefully it'll just go away this year. But it is so, so annoying. So anyways, okay. So that's all I did was I just glued my top layer down to the matte layer. And then what I do with this, before I actually put it onto the base, I'm going to go ahead and take the first little section of the ribbon. And my first section of ribbon will go about here on the card. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this on now before I actually glue that onto the base layer. So let me find my scissors, of course, they're nowhere around. Okay, sorry about that. Hey there. Okay, so I'm just gonna cut the ribbon about that length there. And then I usually cheat, which I'm gonna do again. And I'm going to take ribbon and I'll flip it over. And then I just tape it onto the back of the card. Such a cheater. But you know what? It doesn't matter. Because whatever's easiest, no one's gonna know, and who cares, right? It turns out really nice. So, that's it. And it doesn't even have to look pretty. There we go. Okay. So, there's that. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna glue this on to the mat portion. Geez, sorry about that. Every time I do a video, there's something wrong. It's either I don't have internet, or I've got a cold, I'm blowing my nose, or there's something going on. Maybe one of these days I'll have a healthy video, right? Okay, here we go. So, here's that layer. Let's just glue that down. This is such a cute little card, and honestly, it's so simple. I mean, you could whip out so many of these. Let me get it even. That's why I love using this glue, because you have time to move it around. There you go. So that's it. Isn't that cute? Can you see the little acorns? Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. All right. So that's it with that. Now, all I'm going to do, I'm already ready to move on to my wobble. Isn't that crazy? So I'm going to put this turkey on here. So this turkey I cut out of Create a Critter. My absolute favorite cartridge that Provocraft has ever put out, and I'm sure I am definitely not alone in that thought. So anyways, Create a Critter, and what I did was I just gave him the little eyeballs. My dogs are barking now. So I gave him the little eyeballs, and I cut him at 4.5 inches. So he's gonna go right about here. Okay, so he's gonna go there. But first I'm gonna put him on his wobble. Try to find his wobble. Here's the wobble. You all know, here's the wobble if you've never seen the videos before. Here's what the wobbles look like. They have this big round side, and then they have a little side here. You'll be able to tell as soon as you open it up. But the small side is the side that goes down on the base of your card. And it says it right here, this side down, so it goes down. Okay, this side here, it says top, so that's your top. So it's going to go on your top layer, which is your item you're going to wobble. So what I'm going to do is make sure he's level first. And Mary over at Cards TV, I'll never forget when she did this, and I thank her every single time I do this. She like sets her item, and now I do too, but she sets it on the wobble first before gluing it or before sticking it down, because if you can see, sometimes they lean over and you want to get it centered properly for the weight, for, you know, because once you put it on the card, it's like gonna fall forward or whatever. So this is like, it was such an awesome idea, I couldn't believe it. So now, every time I go to put a wobble on, I have to make sure that I get him, or whatever I'm putting on, as level as possible. You know, it's obviously, you don't have to be perfect at it, but see, look at that. Now he's pretty much level. And then I just kind of lift him up from the back and see where I've got it. Okay, that's pretty easy. See, I'm going to, when I put it on, I'm just going to put it like right underneath those little things there, because that's where he shows to be level. So thank you, Mary, for teaching me that. Let's get this wobble on this sucker. So you peel that off, and then you want to stick this on. I'm going to put it on. Like I said, it's going to go right about at the edge of where those little things were. Okay. Rub it on there. Okay, so there you go. And he's gonna go right here. Ah, he's gonna be so cute when he starts wobbling. Ooh, a little aggressive with his leg there. Okay, so he's gonna go there. Actually, I can go ahead and stick them on. Well, now I'm going to make sure I have everything else on right first. Then I've got the little tag, and this is so cute. I just used the same base, or the same matte color paper, like the creamy one, and then I ink the edges of it in brown. It's actually the Stampin' Up! Chocolate Chip. And then I stamp the little sentiment that says, "Gobble till you wobble." Oop. There you go. Is that not so cute? I love it. And this came from one of my favorite stamp girls. They're the Scrappy Moms. And they have, without a doubt, next to Jada Blossom, they have my other absolute favorite stamps in the world. I just love these. Love these, love these, love these stamps. This is kind of an older set, actually. It's called A Holiday to Remember. And this one has that Gobble Till You Wobble sentiment on it. It has some Christmas stuff on it. This is a really, really good set, you guys. So head on over to the Scrappy Moms website and check it out. I'll put their link on the end of the video like I usually do. Last year I used this Candy Cane Lane. I used that on something too. Oh, it was so cute. I loved it. So I love, love, love this set. So you guys, again, definitely head over and check out the Scrappy Moms. Sorry, I can't fit it in the... See? Scrappy Moms. You'll love them. Okay. So there's that. And with this, I'm just going to put some little pop dots on it. Actually, not little ones, but the larger ones. These here. I'm going to put these on. I'm going to go ahead and put two of them on. Okay. I'll lay it there for a second. I feel like my turkey, see how he's kind of, I don't know if you guys can see how he's kind of leaning over to the side. But I feel like, I think I can take this guy off and see. I mean, it sticks really good, but fortunately he didn't like stick really, really good where I was able to move that. Let me make sure. It'll stick again too, so I'm not worried about that, but I want to get this guy straight because for some reason he kind of went crooked on me. Eddie, what are you eating? Eddie's eating stuff off the floor in my craft room. It's not a good thing. Probably candy from all the things that I've been making. Oh, for heaven's sakes, I can't get this wobble to go straight this time. All right, I think I understand. Okay, that's gonna be better. All right, sorry about that. Sorry about that. I had to get my little guy to go even here. I think he was a little bit crooked. Okay, so we're gonna take the back off. Okay. And we're going to stick this. Oh, let's see. I'm going to kind of slide it up underneath that ribbon a little bit because I want them to be down here. Alright. And then I'm going to go up underneath here. Go up underneath it and make sure you're pressing it down on top of the paper really good. So. Okay, and that's in a good spot. Okay, so this is just so simple. I'm going to fix his leg. And that's really it. I mean, this is the simplest card. It's pretty much done. I just have to put the stuff on the inside. So, what do you think of this, huh? Let me see if I can move the camera up a little bit. I'm not showing you my total mess behind me. Okay, so how cute is this? Gobble till you wobble! Doop. Look at that guy. He's definitely wobbling. This guy has been like, whoa, eating way so much. Okay. What do you think? Isn't he the cutest? Look at him moving. Woo! I cannot wait to get this summer. How cute. Now, the other thing I'm sure, okay, let me just do this. I'm going to go ahead and put a bow on it because I can't stand it. I can't stand it without a bow. Let me see if, can I just do one of these quick deals? Just something? I mean, does that look terrible? Let me see. See, it's not like, there's a lot of, you know, when you're making a project, there's a lot of, well, let's see if that works type of thing. And then you just tear it off if it doesn't. I don't know, that doesn't look too bad. What do you think? Added that little bow on there? I think it turned out all right. It just needed something right there, so that's what we got. Ta-da! Double till you wobble, folks. There you go. That's episode number 5 of Let It Wobble Tuesday. So don't forget, go over and become a follower. Please become a follower for Gail. She needs some followers and got a really cute little blog. And the name's great. And I will go ahead and leave the information for Scrappy Moms, and I will definitely leave you the link to go get your own wobbles so you can get started. Christmas is coming, and you know how everyone likes that little kid on the rocking horse and rocking around the Christmas tree and all that stuff. You're definitely going to want some wobbles for these Christmas cards, folks. So head on over when you get this link. Go over there, buy them out, because they're going to be scarce come Christmas. Everyone is going to be buying them. So head on over there and get them. I will have all of that on the end of the video. And don't forget, tell your friends, leave comments, become followers, and be entered into the drawing for the next for this episode's winner to win another 6 wobbles. Okay? Anyways, thanks for joining me. Sorry I'm sick again. Hopefully next time you see my video for episode number 6, I won't be sick. 6 and sick. Anyway, enough. Good night. Thanks for coming.
From the moment the lights went off, everything had changed. Lie awake.